Lots of logistics going up here with kids. It's awesome. I saw a rear ender about to happen, but it was averted. You guys look pretty happy. What's going on?
Kind of psyched.
Thank you for honoring Gavin and Marlea with your presence here today. We're gathered here today to celebrate the union of two lives in the sight of God and the presence of family and friends, to join together this man and this woman in marriage, which is commended to be honorable among all mankind. And therefore it is not by any to be entered into lightly, but with reverence, commitment, and joy. In this sacred relationship, Gavin and Marlea now come to be joined. They bring two families together to create another, separate but connected. And we do thank you for coming, and we just want to remember at this time that we have loved ones that are looking down on us right now. Marlea's dad, Rick, and Gavin's mom, Christine, and Marlea's brother, Brian. And we just wish they were here today, and I'm sure they're celebrating up in heaven. This time we're going to hear from 1 Corinthians 13, and Kira, Marlea's niece, is going to come up and read.
If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels but have not love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains but have not love, I am nothing. If I give away all I have, and if I deliver up my body to be burned but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love does not envy or boast. It is not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice with wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. As for prophecies, they will pass away. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will pass away.
Thank you, Kira. Well, I want to challenge you two today a little bit, and the rest of us here. A lot of times we sit like most North Americans, and a lot of weddings are like spectator sports, and we're just sitting in the stands waiting for our hot dogs and beer. But I would commend you people, as you're part of the lives of these two, that you're going to hang in there with them through thick and thin over the years. And my challenge is that it's not just a day where everything looks nice and beautiful and we have a wedding album, but this is the beginning of a life together that's going to last till they're old and gray. And so I just commend all of you to really contribute whatever you can in prayer and kind words and shoulder to cry on through good times and bad, that you're going to stick it in with these guys. And I want to hear everybody say I do. Okay, thanks. We need to acknowledge that marriage was instituted by God himself. In fact, Jesus loved a good celebration. His first miracle happened in a little town called Cana. And here's the story. It's from John chapter 2. On the third day, a wedding took place in Cana in Galilee. Jesus' mother was there, and Jesus and his disciples had also been invited to the wedding. When the wine was gone, Jesus' mother said to him, "They have no more wine." Jesus, who was, you know, pretty feisty, actually said, "Woman," or maybe "Mother, why do you involve me?" Jesus replied, "My hour has not yet come." Some people, you know what that mother's, the son, mother-daughter relationship's like, so you get that one. His mother said to the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." Nearby stood six stone water jars, the kind used by the Jews for ceremonial washing, each holding from 20 to 30 gallons. Jesus said to the servants, "Fill the jars with water," so they filled them to the brim. Then he told them, "Now draw some out and take it to the master of the banquet." They did so, and the master of the banquet tasted the water that had been turned into wine. He did not realize where it had come from, though the servants who had drawn the water knew. Then he called the bridegroom aside and said, "Everyone brings out the choice wine first, and then the cheaper wine, after the guests have had too much to drink. But you have saved the best till now." What Jesus did here in Cana of Galilee was the first of the signs through which he revealed his glory, and his disciples believed in him. And for you two, the best is saved till now, and you got each other. Someone once said that the water looked up at its creator and blushed. And I thought that was kind of a neat thing. But the thing that really strikes me about this passage, that Jesus takes the ordinary, the everyday things of life and makes them extraordinary. And as your life starts together, those little ordinary things, day in and day out, need to become extraordinary. And that'll happen if you glue them together with love. At the end of the ceremony, legally you'll be husband and wife, but you still must decide each and every day that stretches before you that you want to be married. Make such a decision and keep on making it daily. For the most important thing in life is to love and to be loved the way God created us. May you always need one another, not so much to fill the emptiness as to help each other. each other know your fullness. May you want one another, but not out of lack. May you embrace one another, but not smother one another. May you succeed in all important ways with each other and not fail in the little graces. Look for things to praise, often say, I love you, and take no notice of small faults. May you have happiness, and may you find it in making each other happy. May you have love, and may you find it in loving one another forever. Through marriage, Gavin and Marlea make a commitment together to face their disappointments, embrace their dreams, realize their hopes, and accept each other's failures. They will promise one another to aspire to these ideals throughout their lives together today, through mutual understanding, openness, and sensitivity to one another. And I'm just really glad to be here because I've only known you for a couple of days and I already love you. That's pretty awesome. I've loved her for a long time. I remember when she was about a foot high and she was just a loud, spunky girl. Now she's a taller, loud, spunky girl. And I'm glad to see that some things never change. So, 7 words to remember. I love you. I'm sorry. And let's pray. I think if you stick to those 3 things in life, things are going to go well. And we are going to hit rough times and hit the wall sometimes. And that's when you got to, you know, be each other's best support and get behind each other and make it work. And then if you need to pick up the phone and say, hey, we need some prayers or we need some money, don't call me for that. Probably won't get that. Do it because we're a family here and we love you guys. And we know how much your love spills out. And I just pray that your house would be one of those places when people come in there, they would feel the love when they hit the front door and that they would feel welcome there. And I know they will. St. Francis of Assisi was once quoted as saying, and I think this has been thrashed around all different ways, but essentially it's this: preach the gospel always and use words when necessary. And our lesson here is actions speak louder than words. So preach to each other the love God puts in your heart, and maybe that'll spill over onto your neighborhood and the people that live around you to see that love and want a part of it, and they're going to be a part of your family also. We now have a poem read by Marlea's niece, Milan.
Love. Love is the strongest feeling known, an all-encompassing passion, an extreme strength, an overwhelming excitement. Love is trying not to hurt the other person, trying not to change the other person, trying not to dominate the other person, and trying not to deceive the other person. Love is understanding each other, listening to each other, and supporting each other, and having fun with each other. Love is not an excuse to stop growing. It's not an excuse to stop making yourself better, and not an excuse to lessen your goals or take the other person for granted. Love is being completely honest with each other, finding dreams to share, and working toward common goals. Sharing responsibilities equally. Everyone in the world wants to love. Love is not a feeling to be taken lightly. Love is a feeling to be cherished, nurtured, and cared for. Love is the reason for life.
Not talking about a year, no, not 3 or 4. I don't want that kind of forever in my life anymore. Forever always seems to be around when it begins, but forever never seems to be around when it ends. So give me your forever, please, your forever. Not a day less will do from you. People spend so much time every single day running around all over town giving their forever away. But no, not me, I won't let my forever roam. Now I hope I can find my forever home. So give me your forever, please, your forever. Not a day less will do from you. like a hammer's clock with numbers, an infinite of time. No, not that forever found only in the mind. Forever only seems to be around when it begins, but forever never seems to be around when it ends. So give me your forever, please, your forever. Not a day less will do from you.
At this time, Gavin has some vows actually to the girls. First word I heard when she stepped up is shade.
Let's see if we can do this without crying. Ready? Okay. Cameron, Mika, Lucy, my girls. You are my most treasured joys. Having you in my life has made it so incredible, so fun, so scary, so nerve-wracking, so happy, so crazy, so busy, and very amazing. I know we haven't had the easiest ride as a family, but together we've conquered more than anybody outside our own group of four will ever really understand. You've loved me unconditionally and have been what's kept me afloat. Our path has shifted. We are traveling in a new journey, one that is exciting and terrifying all at once. Yet it is a journey full of hope and promise of a bright future, full of fun, love, and surprises. I know that you can see Gavin loves me, and I love him. You've seen Mummy transform into a more confident, secure, joyful person since Gavin came into our lives. He is my best friend, and I'm so honored that he has chosen to take us as his family. He loves you girls so very much. Your rays of sunshine added to his day, and I have enjoyed watching your relationships and all their uniqueness grow with him. Gavin is here to care for us, to be our friend, to keep us laughing and well-fed. He's not just taking on me, which in itself is a handful. He's taking on a family of four girls and a dog, a girl dog. He's either brave and in love or just crazy. I respect him immensely for his love and support that he has given to us girls. Will this be an easy ride? What do you think? No. Oh, I love optimism! Woohoo! It's going to be fun, but there's going to be plenty of bumps and tears and frustrations and lessons learned by all of us. But in all of this, there will be a constant run of jokes, amazing memory making, and delicious dinners. We are all grounded in this love, and no matter what we face it together to come out as a fantastic family of five and a dog.
That dog might be the deal breaker. Cameron, Mika, and Lucy, I want you to know that I dearly love your mother. We have become very good friends over the weeks and months, and in fact, have fallen madly in love with each other, in case you haven't been on Facebook lately. As I transition into becoming a daily part of your lives, I want you to know that I care deeply, deeply about each one of you. I promise to be fair and to be honest, to be available for you as I am for your mom, and in due time to earn your love, your respect, and true friendship. I will not attempt to replace anyone, but to make a place in your hearts that is for me alone.
I will be stepfather and friend, and I will cherish my life with all of you. On this day, when I marry your mom, I promise to also love and support you as my own. Your mom and I want to give you these bracelets, each with a charm of a cross and the first letter of your names. The bracelets are symbolic of the joining of us all together as a family. Over the coming years, you will be able to add charms to your bracelets from the meaningful experiences that we will all share with each other.
The first time I've ended up as a flower girl, too. Marlea, you're never nervous. That's crazy.
I'm excited, happy, nervous.
Oh my gosh, it's hard. Who doesn't have sweaty hands?
Gail prayed for sun, it's her fault. Gavin, you've got a lot to learn in a house full of women.
Yeah.
That's all I can say. And do the vows. They've written their own vows. I haven't even read them yet, but they've got this very organized little color-coded book here. It's working great.
Marlea, I stand here ready to take you to be my wife, best friend, and lifelong partner in marriage. You are my soulmate. From that very first FaceTime, there was no doubt we were destined to be together. It was just a matter of when. As husband and wife, we will be the most dynamic duo around. We will have nonstop adventure and excitement, from crazy runs with obstacles to trips to the ER. To raising three beautiful, amazingly awesome girls together, even more trips to the ER. From this moment on, with you at my side, I promise to always live by the vows I make today. I promise to tell you I love you and tickle your back on a regular basis. Hold you and comfort you in times of need and care for you when you are sick. I will be there for you in the best of times and in the worst of times, in our triumphs and in our failures. I promise to love you unconditionally, to support you in your goals, to honor and respect you, to laugh with you and cry with you, and to cherish you and to protect you for all eternity.
Do you, Gavin, take Marlea to be your wife, to live together after God's ordinance, in the holy estate of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor, and keep keep her in sickness and in health, for richer, for poorer, for better, for worse, in sadness and in joy, to cherish and continually bestow upon her your heart's deepest devotion, forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto her as long as you both shall live.
I do, and I will, and anything else, yes.
Woo! All right. I would say that's an affirmative. Okay. I can see you guys are going to have fun. That's good.
Gavin, what an adventure this has been. From the outside, I'm sure this has seemed like one of the craziest relationships ever. But from the inside, close to your heart, holding your hands, this, you and me, is absolutely perfect. You have shown me what sacrificial, patient, compassionate, exciting, generous, and passionate love is. I simply never dreamed this would be a reality for me. To be loved and cherished by you is an awesome gift. Gavin, you've been my friend for years, and you are my true love. You are my playmate, my confidant, my best friend. To love you is a privilege. To you, my sweet, sweet skater boy, I promise faithfulness and patience, respect and lightheartedness, attentiveness and self-improvement. I will celebrate your triumphs and love you all the more for your failures. I promise to always strive to meet your needs, not out of obligation, but because it delights me to see you happy. I promise to keep myself open to you, to let you into my innermost fears and feelings, secrets and dreams. I promise to respect, admire, and appreciate you for who you are, as well as the person you wish to become. I am thrilled I get to grow alongside you and promise to be willing to face change as we both change, keeping our relationship alive and exciting, adventurous, and full of passion. I promise to cheer for the U.S. when they play teams other than Canada. And to try new food, including seafood. I promise to be your sidekick, your running partner, cheerleader, sous chef, and wife. I promise you myself to love you completely and forever.
Do you, Marlea, take Gavin to be your husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, for richer, for poorer, for better, for worse, in sadness and in joy, to cherish and continually bestow upon him your heart's deepest devotion, forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto him as long as you both shall live? What token of love do you offer? Gavin, in placing this ring on Marley's finger, repeat after me.
Marlea, you are now set apart to me as my wife. From this day forward, I give you this ring as a pledge of my love and as a symbol of our unity. And with this ring, I take you as my wife.
Marlea, in placing this ring on Gavin's finger, repeat after me.
Gavin, you're now consecrated to me as my husband. From this day forward, I give you this ring as a pledge of my love and a symbol of our unity. And with this ring, I take you as my husband.
May you always share with each other the gifts of love. Be one in heart and mind. May you always create a home together that puts in your hearts love, generosity, and kindness. Inasmuch as Gavin and Marlea have consented together in marriage before this company of friends and family, and have pledged their faith and declared their unity by giving and receiving a ring, they are now joined. You have pronounced yourselves husband and wife, but remember to always be each other's best friend. What therefore God has joined together, let no man separate. And so, by the power vested in me by this province, and the Lord Jesus Christ, I now pronounce you man and wife, and may your days be good and long upon the earth. Gavin, you may kiss your bride. Woo! Hey, we're going to eat right after we pray, okay? Okay. Bow with me, please. God bless you, Gavin. May your strength be Marlea's protection. May your character be her anchor in storms. May you so live that she will always find in you a safe harbor. God bless you, Marlea. May you have wisdom and understanding and great faith in God that will make you a compassionate partner to Gavin. May you have that inner beauty that never fades. And Jesus, we thank you for being in the midst here today and bringing these people together over the years. And I just thank you that you've got a plan for our lives and it unfolds before us. And a lot of times we go around a corner and we see something completely new and exciting that was never even on the radar before. I just thank you that you're the God who plans our steps. I pray that their household would honor you and that you would bless them greatly. We thank you for friends and family. We pray you'd be bestowing your blessings upon everyone that's here today and take everyone home safely. And we just pray now that we'd have an awesome celebration in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I now present to you Mr. Gavin and Marlea Burgess. They're going to have a little receiving line around where the pool is, and then only immediate family is going to come back here for some family pictures. So if everyone wants to move that direction and then clear out of this area, they can...
Sorry about that.
I want this letter grounded.
I wouldn't even bother to bring him over. I don't think it's possible.
Okay. I heard they said it. She said
it. Yeah. Oh, I did. Yeah. Oh, yeah. And I felt him go, oh.
All over
his. I know, I was off.
Am I blind?
I gave
to my coworker.
Go for it.
Why don't some good job, please?
So I got this other one.
Good.
Recording right now.
I'm gonna. This is my cousin Lori. And finally.
I've seen you somewhere before.
Thank you.
I know. Yeah, tell me about it.
Oh, yeah, the
some shade over there.
Awesome. I got one. My cousin John. Let's get present now.
You're related now.
I got right one. You're the gorgeous thing.
I love that hat. Why does that hat look?
As about 5 minutes, we're on the table. Your name is Simon. Your name is over here. Okay. Yes. Yes.
Questions I could ask, and I suggest you volunteer to sing.
Lucy has a really good one. It's been pre-vetted.
It's on! No.
Okay, I want to know who connected to who first.
Yeah, that's a good one also. Who reached out first on Facebook?
That's a really convoluted, long thing.
Well, someone did it first. How was you?
Mommy, don't talk to me.
You can't share answers.
I'll tell you.
Yeah, Megan knows the answer. Okay, I'm answered.
You can't even remember. That was notable.
Really, a kiss ought to be done, right? So here's what happens. You got to stand up in plain view of everybody, preferably with your own spouse. Just saying, right? Preferably with your own spouse, and then you show them, you know, you married folk with experience, right? Who know how to, well, I'm not going to single out the men and say this is totally your responsibility, but you know how to love your women. Right? So you show them how it's done. Now, if, on the other hand, it's going slow and there's not very much action, then I have been prompted to start calling names. I didn't choose the names from the hat, and you'll be put on the spot.
Oh, wow.
Yes. Now, you know, it's not meant to be ridicule. It's meant to be all in good fun. And you're not likely to get in trouble for this.
Sounds like it's a lot.
However, you won't want to disappoint.
In the bottle.
Okay, so since we're somehow got a little messed up on our agenda here, we're going to insert the newlywed game here. I'm sorry about that. We're going to have to wait a couple minutes before we eat. So here's what we're going to do. Well, questions are okay. Come on up here. So we're going to do the newlywed game. You got to take off one shoe, Gavin.
One shoe.
Come sit in this chair.
Okay. Why do you take off one
shoe? You'll see. It'll become evident.
I know what you mean. I just need one big girl. Thank you.
Okay. So I have a list of approved questions that was submitted to me by the bride and the groom. But since those have yet to arrive, I will just open it up to the floor. Does anybody have a question that they would like to ask of the bride and the groom to see how well they know each other? Anybody, just stick your hand up and I'll give you the mic. Yes, ma'am.
Everybody would put their hands. Who said I love you first?
Duh.
Okay, oh yeah. Does Gavin know how this game works?
Okay, I need to know how this game works.
Okay, Gavin, this is how the game works. You have one of your shoes, and you have one of, and you have one of mine.
Oh, I need another shoe.
Take your other shoe off. Sorry, did you just not come on? All right. Okay, so here's how the game works for you two. So if you think What was the question? Who said I love you first? If you think that Marlea said I love you first, then you hold up Marley's shoe. And Marlea, you would hold up whoever shoe you think said first. So, here's the questions. So, who said I love you first? There you go. Okay, so I kind of like this. I kind of like this better. Let's skip this.
Over FaceTime, Facebook, or
Post-it. Oh, that's tricky. Okay, so does anybody else have an unofficial question that they want to ask? Yes, sir.
Are you saying it?
Who shows more public displays of affection on Facebook? Okay, who else? Come on, we're getting rolling here. Yeah. Oh, yes. Okay, anybody else? In the back, and then up front here. Shoot, I'm going to start.
Where are the people we planted?
Which is the better hockey team, the Vancouver Canucks or the San Jose Sharks? This is an important question, Gavin.
Gavin.
The Canucks are my shoe, and the Jose Sharks are yours.
Jose
Sharks!
Jose Sharks! All right.
Now you're safe at my house next time.
All right. Who's the better cook, Gavin or Marlea?
Well, that's a given.
All right.
Yes, ma'am.
Wait, you don't think I cook it? Who's better,
Who spent more money on the dress or the suit?
Now we're getting down to the brass tacks. Okay, anybody else? I'll start reading up.
Oh,
you should have said.
Do you have a question?
Oh, my God.
You have
a question? You have a say?
Who loved them first?
Who loves them the most?
Who loves each other the most? Oh, what?
Okay, any other takers?
Come on.
There we go. Here we go. Mother of the bride. Now we're talking. Here we go.
Oh, no, mommy.
This is really quite personal, but I want to know. I want to know on any given Saturday morning who all is going to be in bed with you. Will you have more than one person in bed with you, or will you have like five and a dog? No dog?
I don't know how to answer that, Mother.
Okay, I have a question. I want to know which one of you sings the best, Gavin or Marlea?
Mom
raised her. Okay. Before your information, Marlea is a fantastic singer. Used to be. She sang at Shirley's wedding.
She is.
Good morning. That's the best song ever.
Okay, anybody else have a question? Yeah, okay. We got you, sir, and you, sir.
Oh, your dad.
All right.
Are you looking worried there, Gavin?
Papa.
No. Who keeps the needle's bedroom?
Who is this?
Very good. Okay, little man in the front. Mr.
Oh my
Ninja.
God,
okay, Ollie.
Yes, do it.
Who takes up the most room on the bed?
Any more Dilatites?
Who got sent to the principal's office for it, Dilat? Questions I could ask, and I suggest you volunteer to sing.
Lucy has a really good one. It's been pre-vetted.
It's on, Malcolm.
Okay, I want to know who connected to who first.
Yeah, that's a good one. Who reached out first on Facebook?
That's a really convoluted long thing.
Well, someone did it first.
Mommy,
don't talk to me.
You can't
share answers.
Yeah,
Megan
knows the answer.
I can't answer.
You can't even remember. That was notable.
Okay. Oh, you got it right.
There you go.
Your daughters have a question.
It's a good one.
I tell Mika for me to tell her this. Who kissed the most people at the DeLong?
Medical question. Has the dog had his shots?
She?
She?
Yes.
Oh, good.
Blue for yes and white for no. Thank you, guys.
All right, so I think we're
Well, that could be too.
Who said that?
All right, we're going to keep this up.
Okay, this is Ollie. He has a joke.
Why does a chicken cross the road?
I don't know, Ollie. Why?
To get to the other side.
That was a really good joke. Lucy Goose has a joke.
Why did the cow cross the road?
I don't know, Lucy. Why?
To get to the movie theaters.
That's very good. Okay, let's get around the wall here.
Why did the turtle cross the road?
I really don't know.
To get to the Shell station.
So good. Okay, I think we should come up. We were doing pretty good with our questions since we're
okay, let's go.
We're almost ready. The foods are almost there, but it's empty. So you can go up if you like. Or we can come up with another question for the bride and the groom. Here, maybe I'll just ask one of these. Except there's not enough light, I can't see now. Okay.